Hello and welcome back to Faith with Flavor. I am so excited to introduce today's guest because he is the most recent member of the TBN Salsa family. Chuckie Perez loves to bring people to tears, but I'm talking about tears of laughter with the self-titled show, The Chuckie Perez Show, airing right here on TBN Salsa. But before we hear from him, if you follow me on social media, you know that I recently went on a trip to the Holy Land, a truly transformational experience for me and a few other members of the TBN Salsa family. Please keep in mind that what you're about to watch are candid and unscripted moments as we travel to a faraway land known as Israel. Take a look. What's up, guys? I'm so excited this morning because I am going to Israel for the very first time. I'm gonna go visit the Holy Land, go where Jesus walked, and right now we're on our way to the airport with this love of my life over here. Say hi. I'm a little sad that he's not going with me, but I'm really excited to see what Israel has in store for TBN Salsa. So stay tuned because I have a lot of footage in store for you. What's up, guys? We're about to land in Israel. I'm so excited. I can't wait. Nate, how do you feel?
I can't wait till I get off this plane. We have about 19 minutes left. It's been a long trip. I'm super excited.
Hey, guys. We made it to Tel Aviv. I'm so excited. We're here in the airport right now, about to go get our luggage. Oh, here it is. Look. Hi, thank you for the warm welcome. We just arrived in our hotel. I'm exhausted right now, but I gotta show you guys the room. We're right overlooking the Sea of Galilee. And it's pretty dark out there right now, but tomorrow I'll show you more. And this is our bathroom. I'm just gonna get ready for dinner. And then we're gonna do our confessionals of what our expectations are for this trip.
I'm excited to kind of create content that will bring hope to many people. If we look at today's world right now that's taking place, there's a lot of devastation, there's a lot of things that are just disheartening. People are looking for hope. People are looking for Christ, and even if they don't know it or not. So more than anything, I'm excited to being a part of this team and just creating content that will bring hope into many homes and inspire people with faith.
I feel like you come to a place sometimes with the Lord where He shows you so much in our lives, or He has shown me so much in my life. But I believe that there's so much more that there is. There's so many facets to God. I believe that even if I lived 10 lifetimes, I would never get to experience all that there is in Christ. But this one lifetime that I have, I just really am digging in hard.
I really want to learn about the Israeli culture, because as much as I love my Hispanic culture, I equally love learning and growing in different cultures and different ethnicities. And I think being here and knowing about the people of Israel, the people, the Jews, that Jesus was a Jew, it's so amazing. And I'm just so excited to get to know more about their culture.
Even starting tomorrow, we're gonna go on the Sea of Galilee, and I just know it's gonna be life-changing. So our heart is that we will be able to show you content that's gonna be able to maybe move your heart, stir your heart, that you will have the passion to be out here in Israel one day also.
So I am super excited to be here. It feels like a dream, really. Like, I cannot believe I'm standing here in the Holy Land in this beautiful hotel with, you know, some people that I love and care for so dearly. And this view is just breathtaking. Like, honestly, like, I cannot believe I'm standing right in front of the Sea of Galilee. It's so beautiful. I mean, pictures don't even do it justice. You have to come here for yourself. Our first breakfast in Israel.
Has a lot of iron in it.
Matt, what do you have there?
I have some bready looking things and some fruit looking things.
Looks delish.
I know.
We've got some cheesecake.
Yeah, we have a lot of cheesecakes here.
So how was your first breakfast at Israel?
Very good. I have to stay away from all of the cheesecake. because then I'm going to blow up like a big balloon. So we're not going to have to go on the hot air balloon. Just get on my back. No, I'm kidding. But it's amazing.
This bread right here, they say that you cook it all night. You bake it, I'm sorry. You make it all night. And it's delicious.
We're on the bus. Everyone say hi. We're getting ready to go to our worship experience on the Sea of Galilee. We're super excited because it's just going to be amazing to be exactly where Jesus, you know, walked on water and performed a bunch of miracles. So we're really looking forward to it. Walking over to our boat for our worship experience on the Sea of Galilee. I'm not gonna lie, guys, this is super awesome. I mean, come on. Like, when can you say that you get to go to Israel and you get to be on a boat and have a worship experience right here on the Sea of Galilee? So cool. I really hope you enjoyed the first part of our Israel vlog, and stay tuned for next week for part two of our trip to the Holy Land, and also to TBN Salsa for the upcoming episodes that will air right here on Faith with Flavor. And now let's hear from the latest addition to the TBN Salsa family, Chuckie Perez.
Hey.
Hi, Chuckie.
How you doing?
How are you?
Thanks for having me.
Good to see you again. It's been a little while.
Yeah, it's been, I think, a year at least. Yeah, it's been a year.
Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. You know, I'm so glad that you're here because I want to talk about your story, talk about your show. There's so much that you have to tell the TBN Salsa audience that's watching today. But let's get started with your childhood. Why don't we talk about, take us way back to the beginning.
Oh, God. Way back.
What was life like for Chuckie,
you know, the kid? I grew up in a Christian home. I was very fortunate. My parents were in a gospel quartet. So that's what got me in music. And so I'd run around the house, you know, like 2 or 3 years old, and be singing. And I think I would fill in sometimes with their rehearsals. They would have rehearsals. Mm. So it was my aunt and uncle, and my mom and dad had a gospel quartet, and they played like, gosh, they played, one year they played like 200 dates in a year. And wow. So I grew up around a really good Christian home. You know, that doesn't mean I received the Lord at 5 years old, but that doesn't mean I lived for Him. You know, I still went through a rebellious period in high school and so on. And it was 18 when I really dedicated my life to the Lord again. So, I can't complain. I have a great, great upbringing.
That's awesome. Your roots were grounded in,
they were
in the Lord.
They were grounded in the Lord, and we were good. We were good Baptist. Love the Baptist, but we were good Baptist people. You know, Jerry Falwell every morning, that type of thing. Later on, like I said, I rebelled against that because it was just religious to me. It wasn't real, you know. Yeah. But as a kid, you know, it kept, you know, Bible drills, learning Bible drills in church and stuff. So I don't have that background of coming from, you know, the world and all that stuff. You know, I can honestly say I was very blessed.
And how did Jesus become real in your life?
You know, I wish I had like an experience where, you know, a light bulb turned on or some, you know, some huge testimony there. My testimony came later in life, but this one was just basically, you know, I just kind of grew up. I really did. I just kind of grew up. I started looking at my life and thinking, what am I going to do with my life? You know, 18 years old, and everybody, all my friends are going to college and everything. I'm sitting there going, what am I going to do? You know? So I started promoting concerts. I said, I want to promote concerts. I love music. So I got involved in music, started promoting concerts, met another artist, and I didn't know what road managing was. I found out real soon and became his road manager, a gospel artist, John Gibson. And traveled with him for years, a couple years, and then I got my record deal. And so I kind of just decided to just had that moment where I just said, I got to take this serious, my walk with the Lord. And started seeking God, and I got excited when I saw people getting saved at these concerts.
Aww.
So I guess that was my little revival there, you know, where I thought, this is really cool, hurting people coming to the altar, giving their life to Christ. And I said, I want to be a part of this, you know. Mm. And so that was a turning point for me. And so that's when I started getting involved in music big time. And I got my first record deal with Maranatha Music. I was 21, yeah. And Roby, I don't know if anybody knows these names, but Roby Duke is a classic. He already went to be with the Lord, but he calls me up and says, hey man, you want a record deal? And I said, yeah, I want a record deal. So I released a record with Maranatha, and I've been doing music ever since.
That's so
touring
awesome.
Touring and everything.
Now, growing up, like, what kind of music were you into? Who did you look up to as the music world?
Gosh, in the gospel side, you know, my sister turned me on to Andre Crouch. Mm. As a kid, I was a little kid, and I was like, who's Andre Crouch? And then found out these guys named the Winans, you know. But in the pop side, I guess, you know, it was, I would run around, like 3 or 4 years old and imitate Elvis everywhere. You know, okay. I loved Elvis. I see the Elvis movies and Michael Jackson.
So would they call you like the Hispanic Elvis?
Yeah, kind of. I did my hair like that too.
You know,
I walk
you?
Around with a brush and go around to do that. Yeah, sure. But I loved rock and roll. I loved to dance. I did know at the age of 14, to be honest with you, I don't share this too much, but I did know what I wanted to do. I wasn't yet committed to the Lord like I should, but when I saw Michael Jackson perform on television, I saw him moonwalk. I said, I want to do that. Because I didn't understand the word charisma, and I just knew he had an it factor. And I knew, I said, I want to do something where it captivates people.
Oh.
You know, and so he made me want to do entertainment, and other artists made me want to write music, and so, you know, so that's kind of where my start was.
Now, you served in very many different capacities, like in ministry.
Yeah, sure.
What kind of things did you do?
Well, growing up in a Christian home, my dad was an assistant pastor for a while, and then he became a pastor. He's been pastoring for, I don't know how many years now, 30-some years. And so I've helped him in the church as a worship leader. Youth minister, then I became an assistant pastor to him. Pretty much directed plays, wrote plays. So I was always involved in that ministry from about 19 on, right after that, 19, for about 3 or 4 years, I was just totally full on, you know, helping my dad out at his church.
Mm.
And so, I've served in different capacities there.
Awesome. So. Now, when did you realize, you know, your show is all about making people laugh.
Yeah, exactly.
But when did you realize that you wanted to do that?
You know, I've always been a class clown, you know.
Okay.
So I don't have, I've heard people say, oh, you know, they've done stand-up for years and so on. Some guy told me one time, you know, I've done stand-up for 30 years. And I said, well, how come you're not funny?
So,
you know, but anyways, but, you know, But we did, what happened was, I look back at my life and I said, I always would do concerts and end up somehow, I did a tour in Colorado, ended up touring and ended up doing jokes in the middle of my, supposed to be a serious concert, right?
Aww.
So I ended up doing jokes and making, and people started laughing. And one time my manager came up here and we did 12 dates through Colorado. I remember him coming up and saying, dude, you might have missed your calling. And I said, what? He says, you were just joking and people were cracking up, and it was like, and he goes, you had them rolling. I said, really? I just was being me, having fun.
Mm.
And I started to see, oh wow, I might have a little something here, you know,
yeah.
Something different. And so, long story short, I've been funny and loving doing comedy for years, but I've actually officially been doing comedy just since the show, which is a year ago, when we put the show together.
Why do you think that God wants people to laugh?
Because it's healing.
Mm.
You know, the joy of the Lord is our strength.
Mm.
And if you don't have any joy, you don't have any strength when you're facing a situation. A lot of times, you know, we say, oh, the word of God, we need the word. Yes, we need the word.
Yes.
That's definite. But there's something about an anointing, a spirit of joy, you know, and I'm a living testimony of that. You know, Proverbs 17:22 says, a happy heart is like good medicine.
Mm.
And so I went through something that, you know, can I share how the show came to be a little bit?
Yeah, sure.
I met you about a year ago.
Yes.
And what happened was you didn't know that in 2014, I went through probably the biggest trial of my life. 2014, I was playing tennis, I was working out and doing this, and I started gasping for air. And I was like, oh my gosh, what's going on? Well, I checked myself, I hate going to doctors, so I checked myself in, and my wife thought it was kind of funny that, she thought it was strange, serious, that why are you going to emergency? I said, I think I need to go in emergency. I went in emergency, long story short, they said I was born with an irregular valve, and that I could have collapsed at any time and died. And I was like, oh my gosh, you know. So in December of 2014, I had to go in for surgery. And open heart surgery. Never thought, you know, I hear other people go through stuff and I'm like, whoa. So it was like, that's a whole show in itself, just explaining everything I went through that time. But I get out in surgery, I almost die. It was supposed to be a 5-hour procedure. They had to replace a valve, fix another valve, and all kinds of stuff. My heart was healthy. They said, everything else, they told me, you're healthy, but you had a irregular heart valve. And so I went in there and almost died because they had to pull me in twice because I was bleeding to death. So in that, coming out of that, God spared my life. Literally, you know, the great physician stepped in because these were the best physicians of USC, mm-hmm. you know, that the world could offer. And they couldn't figure out how to stop it. But something happened at a time. People were praying, and God stepped in and healed me.
Wow.
So, and delivered me. Psalms 107:20 says, He sent His word and healed us and delivered us from destruction.
Amen.
And I used to quote that all the time up until the surgery. And God told me one time, I said, Lord, You didn't heal me. I expected a healing, you know? And He says, no, I delivered you. And I said, He goes, I gave you a different testimony, a testimony of deliverance. So when I came out, I'm now emotionally healing.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody would book me. Nobody, for some reason, all my friends, pastors, all the bookings went. Nobody's around. I get a call a year, almost a year to the date. My surgery a year later, the end of 2015 now. I get a call to come meet you. There's this new TBN Salsa, you know, Mark called and said, hey, come down, I want you to meet her. And I said, oh man, you know, maybe I can, this is good, it's a break, you know, maybe I can go and sing or something, or, you know. So I come down and you walk up, you were so gracious, and you walk up, we sat right up there, my wife and I were sitting up there, it's Christmas time, you had no idea. But you walk up and you said, you had me come and do a quick spot with the green and say something nice about TBN Salsa. I said, sure, you know, I was still unfamiliar at the time.
Uh-huh.
You guys are great, but at that time I was like, I didn't know, I was a whirlwind for me. And you had me come out, I did that, and then you came up and said, okay, so where's your show? And I said, I'll have it to you in 3 weeks. And you know, I don't know if you remember that. And you said, okay, great, here's my email. And you walked off, I'm like, so I turn around, my wife says, what show? I said, I don't know. I'm gonna have to come up with a show.
By faith,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, by faith show. I said, and the Lord showed me, and I said, I wrote this down one time on Facebook. I post stuff sometimes. I said, no, never opened any doors. No, never took me anywhere. Say yes.
I love that.
So,
and we actually have your show, a little clip of your show that we want to show our audience right now. Take a look at the Chuckie Perez Show.
The Chuckie Perez Show. Late night has never been this funny.
Hey guys, if you just started tuning in, that was a short clip letting you know that the Chuckie Perez Show is now on TBN Salsa, and Chuckie Perez is right here with me, Chuckie.
Yeah.
Thank you for that.
Yeah. You saw me spray painting.
Yeah. You know, you could just tell from that little short clip that it's just a very fun vibe.
It's, yeah.
A very family-friendly show.
Yeah.
How did the concept of the show come
about? Well, like I said, when I left, I thought, what show am I going to do? And I thought, well, everybody's, you know, I preach, but everybody's preaching. We got some really good preachers and a lot of great preachers on TBN Salsa. And I thought, wow, what do I do? It's different, you know? And the Lord reminded me, says, what brought you through while you were in the hospital? What brought you through, you know? Because I played jokes on my mom walked in one time and I was laying there recuperating. She walked in. I said, Mom, can you unplug that? It was my phone, right? So she unplugged something. I go, not that one. You know, I freaked her out. So she went, oh, don't do that. You know,
so I said,
I was playing jokes like that. And the Lord reminded me, humor got me through,
yes.
You know? Laughter was a healer. And it really was. I was, you know, I said, that's right. He says, do something that just shows laughter, that brings healing.
Aww.
So I thought, okay, what's lacking in, I guess, in Christian television, but in television, period, is like a late night show format that's clean, that's for the whole family. Because
yeah.
we have late night shows out there, there's a lot of innuendos,
mm-hmm.
you know? And I didn't want it to be real preachy. Like I said, there's great preachers. I wanted it to just be funny, clever, and clean.
I love that.
You know, and so.
And you know, can I just say
yeah,
this one thing?
Sure.
What I love about what you're doing is that you're literally walking in your giftings. You know, the show is a direct representation of your giftings. Like, you know, you have music on there.
Yeah,
and you have laughter on there. And these are things that were birthed inside of you from a very young age.
Yeah, that's the thing. It's like, God, I thought, God, you're so awesome. You know, I love music. I raised in music. I love the word. I love the minister. That's my heart is ministry. Mm-hmm. I said, but I love making people laugh. You know, life of the party, come in, make jokes and stuff. So here I'm writing now. I sit there and go, I'm writing songs still. I'm writing sermons still. And I'm writing monologues, jokes, and sketches. And mm-hmm. so I encourage everybody, just watch this show. You can even go to the website and see some past episodes, but see the current episodes here on TBN Salsa. And it bring the whole family around because it's funny.
Yeah.
We have great guests on, interview guests.
And you also, you kind of do like a little monologue with others. You know, there's many people involved
yeah.
in your program.
Yeah, there's
Tell
a lot.
It's
not just me. It's a whole team. I'm just the host and creator of it, you know. But we have people that come on. I have a guest comedians that come on and do stand-up comedy. We have great bands. Brian Duncan Band is my house band.
Mm.
He's legend in gospel music. And he's even been in some sketches. And so they're just nutty stuff that we do. We go right at the edge
uh-huh.
and don't cross over. That's the thing. We take you there. You know, we bring up some stuff and everybody gets their fair dose. We get Obama, we got Clinton, we got Trump, we hit everybody. You know, we make fun of, I make fun of myself and, you know, everybody, we make fun, everybody gets it, but it's to laugh, you know? And so, anyways, but yeah.
So what do you want your audience to gain out of watching your program?
Joy. Mm. I mean, that you can actually tune in to the show and you could have the worst day you had, you know, of the week. You could be in the hospital. We've been getting letters from people even in prison and from a lot of non-believers. That's the coolest thing. When non-believers are watching the show,
wow.
That's awesome because they're watching, they cross through, they laugh at it, and then find out, oh, this is Christian, you know, at the
wow.
very end. But I want people to get joy. I want them to see that they can watch something wholesome and clever, but quality. You know, it's not real churchy, you know what I mean? It's not churchy, and we're not throwing scriptures and trying to make that funny and all church jokes. They're just jokes,
yeah.
but they're clean. And they're just clean sketches, you know, that touch on topics and great musicians and stuff. It's very, it goes back to that era before we were born, okay, that where the whole family would gather around the TV and be able to watch TV together. It's that.
I love that. But what I love about what you just said is that you said that non-believers are watching
yes.
your program because yeah. that's our mandate as
right.
believers.
Right.
Our mandate is to reach the lost, the
right.
ones that don't know Christ, and you're doing that.
I didn't want to just entertain Christians.
Mm.
I wanted a minister's family, any Christian family, to go and tune in and watch just because it was good. But I wanted to basically reach out to non-believers too,
Amen.
To draw them in, you know. So I think we're doing that, praise God. You know?
Yeah, and I'm so glad you're a part of our family.
Oh, I'm honored, I really am.
You know, I really feel that every person that I meet or, you know, that we talk to, it's like, it's a God-ordained meeting, you know. I don't pick people. God
right.
leads me to people just like he led me to you.
Yeah, no.
But for you, like, this network is all about reaching the Hispanic American community with the gospel. What does this network, TBN Salsa, mean to you?
You know, growing up, I didn't speak Spanish. I speak what I called Spanglish.
Mm.
So it's like, I joke around, it's Taco Bell Spanish, you know? So it's like, I wasn't accepted, you know, in the Spanish speaking market, you know, area. And I wasn't accepted in all English. I was that guy in between.
Yeah.
And so I'm like, where do I fit? You know, when I signed record deals, they were like, you should do, I'd have them tell me, you should do some Spanish music. And I'm like, I don't, and I have, but I don't speak it.
Yeah.
So I felt bad. I don't speak Spanish that well. And at the same time, you know, I wasn't accepted into English. So I'm sitting there going, this is a platform for second, third generation Latinos that, and it's huge. You know, I'm glad that TBN, I'm glad you and Matt, Lori Crouch, and Pastor, I can't think off the top of my head.
Samuel Rodriguez,
yes, Pastor Sam, that they got that vision and they moved on it and they did it because there is a generation right now that of talent, a generation that are anointed, and they're a Latino generation and they're English speaking, and we need to reach them.
Amen.
And they're out there. They're out there. These young people are out there, yeah, that have the same goals, same desires that I have growing up. But now they have a channel they can actually tune into and get inspired from, you know.
Yes, amen.
And so,
talk to them right now. Talk to those viewers
well,
that are watching.
You know, I want to encourage you today. I'm here today. It's a miracle that I'm here because I'm a miracle. I'm alive, first of all, but it's a miracle. I want to tell you that God can, one year to the next, change you dramatically. He can change your purpose, your future, your destiny dramatically, and give you that purpose, actually, give you that future. You know, I believe this, that whatever you went through yesterday, whatever you're going through today, is not your tomorrow. So stay faithful at what you're doing. Trust God, and God will take you places you've only dreamt of. He'll open doors that no man can shut for you. So I want to encourage you, keep dreaming big and keep putting Jesus first.
Amen. Chuckie, well said.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for being here.
Yeah.
Such an honor to have you.
Thanks.
And thank you to all my viewers watching Faith with Flavor. I love you guys so much. If this show has blessed you in any way, I would love to hear your comments and your questions. You can find me on www.lifewithdonna.com and let me know your thoughts. And remember, make this the best day. You know, God has so much in store for you. He loves his children, and no eye has seen, no ear has heard the things which God has prepared for those who love him. God bless you.